Forbes.com reported this week that a record 290 newcomers joined the Forbes billionaire list in the last year as world markets defied international turmoil. While wars, diseases, and currency crises made up the headlines, tycoons from every continent, except for Antarctica, managed to mint new 10-figure fortunes. The United States ranks second in contributing. We gave 57 new billionaires to this list. Who's the most famous rookie on the billionaire list, maybe you're asking? Michael Jordan, just doing it. With just under 23 million households, or 46.5 million persons, rely on food stamps in this same country. 20% of American youth are now dependent upon food stamps. According to the figures in a USDA report on the agency's website, the states with the largest documented food stamp recipients appear to be predominantly run by progressive, secular, ungodly, and non-constitutionally minded political officials. Most of these states have also adopted sanctuary policies, which is unconstitutional and therefore unlawful government programming. And some experts even declare this policy to be a crime against their citizens. Many of you have heard of Charles Darwin, a failed preacher and a wannabe scientist from the 1800s. He was the one who popularized the evolutionary model of origins through his book, On the Origin of Species by Means of Natural Selection, or the Preservation of Favored Races in the Struggle for Life. In his book, Darwin documented the simple pattern of life: overproduction, struggle for survival, survival of the fittest, and then reproduction of like kinds. Though Darwin did not develop this model into a philosophical worldview, as many mistakenly believe, many of his contemporaries adopted it as a worldview and applied its dangerous thesis to far-reaching subjects like law and government. Perhaps one of the most prodigious pioneers of this worldview, Herbert Spencer, nicknamed Darwin's Bulldog, made Darwin's model a philosophy and worldview, social Darwinism. He wrote extensively showing how evolution is the unifying principle affecting and underlying every academic discipline. This social Darwinism, when applied in the field of economics, creates a situation where government picks winners and losers regarding class and wealth, much like hyenas feeding on a carcass. Tooth and claw, cutthroat competition is created for government favor. This is quite unlike biblical capitalism, which is based on free markets, but with an emphasis on compassion and moral responsibility. You see, when government begins to control all aspects of life and starts picking winners and losers, a totalitarian regime is created. The 20th century is filled with examples of how this type of government no longer protects the rights of the individual. Soon the entire culture disintegrates, which leads to the strong preying on the vulnerable. The middle class, the supporting class, then collapses. When a nation directs its economy using biblical principles of free markets, capitalism is tempered with morality, since the individual guides his business practices with love your neighbor as yourself attitude. This biblical capitalism thrives and grows in a constitutionally limited government, this environment where churches and nonprofits can adequately fill their role as the institutions of charity, which feed the hungry, clothe the naked, and comfort the brokenhearted. If we do not reject this evolutionary worldview and return to a government which uses the American view as its standard, I believe we will see more billionaires, bigger government, and more food stamps. This is Jake MacAulay with the Institute on the Constitution, bringing you the American View.